morning to one and all present here. Today I am going to teach about introduction to optical fiber communications. Introduction to optical fiber communication. As we know, what do you mean by communications? It is a process of conveying information from one place to another place. The communication is mainly classified into two methods based on the medium or channel. Based on the channel or medium, one is wire communication, another one is wireless communications. Wire communication. Another one is wireless communication. So this wire communication, we can give some example like telephone communication system and coaxial cable communication and optical fiber communication system. Then wireless communications, we can give some example like radar communication and satellite communications, etc. So here, this optical fiber communication system comes under wire communications. See, that optical fiber communication system, it is having lot of advantages compared to existing all other communication system like wireless and wire communication system, telephone communications and coaxial cable communication systems. So what are the advantages of optical fiber communication system? The major point is lower attenuation. Lower attenuation, then second one is higher bandwidth. The fiber communication system having higher bandwidth. Then third major point is there is no electromagnetic interference. There is no EMI. Simple form, you can say that there is no electromagnetic interference. Then fourth point is a flexible, more flexible communication systems. Flexibility is more. And then fifth point is, we can say that more channel handling capacity since it is having higher bandwidth. Okay, fifth one is more channel handling capacity. Channel handling capacity. So these are the major advantages of optical fiber communication system compared to all other existing communication system. We can say that lower attenuations compared to other communication, it is giving only 0.2 dB per kilometer. Higher bandwidth, of course, optical communication system having a bandwidth 10 to the power 13 to 10 to the power 15 hertz is the bandwidth. Then of course there is no electromagnetic interference since the fiber is made up of silica, dielectric medium. There is a lot of flexibility in the communication and more channel handling capacity. Because of these advantages, we are going for optical fiber communication systems. Now I'm going for how that light is traveling through optical fiber. So you can say that light ray transmission. Light ray signal transmission. As we know already about the light signal transmission through optical fiber is based on total internal reflections. So what do you mean by total internal reflection? We can define that term. How the light is going to be travel with full of total internally reflected back and forth in the optical fiber. How the phenomena is happen? Let us go through the diagram and explain about how total internal reflection is occur in optical fiber. Okay. Let us consider the two refract index medium of the fiber. Okay, so this is a N1 refract index medium and this is N2 refract index medium. Okay, let us consider two refract index medium, N1 and N2. N1 is greater than N2. Let us say N1 is greater than N2. Let us put that plane, normal plane, in between N1 and N2 medium. So now that light is going to enter from N1 medium with a certain angle, input angle, that is known by, you know, pi i, incident angle. When the light is incident at the intermediate interface of the two different media, N1 and N2, that light is to get refracted with depending upon the incident angle. Okay, with respect to incident angle. So now we can say that this is a refracted angle. Pi r, refracted angle. So ultimately what happened, that light, but incident angle at the interface and get into the another medium with the refracted angle pi r with respect to normal plane. Now that when you increase that incident angle, see that second diagram. When you increase the incident angle little bit more, you know, pi I, you know, the refracted angle, you know, the refracted angle will be only on the interface of the medium. So when the pi I is, when the incident angle, the light is incident on the particular angle at the different refract index medium, okay, it's getting to the only on the interface of two different media, N1 and N2, the particular angle is known as a critical angle, pi c. Okay, so now what happened, the refracted angle, the pi r is become, you know, 90 degree when pi I equal to pi C. See here, when pi I equal to pi C, the refracted angle become 90 degree. So-called it is a critical angle. What do you mean by critical angle? Angle at which the complete light will be travel only through the interface of two different medium, N1 and N2. This is known as a critical angle. Now I am going to change that incident angle. Let us see here. Let us put N1 and N2. When I increase that incident angle more than that, now see that pi I is greater than pi C. Okay, incident angle more than that, you know, pi c, that complete light will be internally reflected back into the same medium N1. No light will be refracted into N2 medium. So called it is a total internal reflection, TIR. Okay, so incident angle is greater than critical angle, total internal reflections will be occur in optical fiber. This is the way the light is traveling through optical fiber for long distance based on the total internal reflections. This is a very important point in optical fiber communication system, how the total internal reflection is occur. Okay, so then let us see that I have told you refract index of medium 1 and refract index of medium 2. What do you mean by refract index? Okay, the refract index is nothing but we can write the refract index is denoted by N. It is nothing but the velocity of light in free space. Velocity of light in free space divided by velocity of light in constant medium. Light in constant medium. Okay, say for example, okay, what is the refract index of air? Okay, that is denoted by N0. Air medium refract index, we can say it is 1. What is the refract index of water medium? You can say that N for water medium, you can say that 1.33. What is the refract index of glass medium? Refract index, this is a water This is a glass equal to 1.5. So this is the way you can differentiate what is the refract index of different medium like air, water and a glass medium. The optical fiber is made up of silica glass which will be useful for long distance communications, and the signal is light signal is traveling based on the total internal reflection. Here the light is considered as a carrier signal carrying the original message signal. But before carrying that light signal, that information, it is in the form of voice converted into electrical. That electrical signal is converted into light that will be traveled through optical fiber with the help of transmitter like LED or laser. With the help of LED laser, that electrical signal converted into light, that light will be traveled through optical fiber based on total internal reflection for long distance. Okay. And the optical fiber is a medium. These are all classified into two types. One is glass optical fiber. Glass optical fiber. Second one is plastic optical fiber. Plastic optical fiber. Okay. Then glass optical fiber mainly classified into two types. One is single mode fiber. Then another one is multi-mode fiber. Then plastic fiber also classified into two types. One is single mode fiber. Then another method is multi-mode fiber. Okay, come to that glass optical fiber. There are two types, single mode and multi-mode fiber. Single mode fiber again classified into two types. One is step index fiber and grade index fiber. But in single mode fiber, grade index fiber is not available commercially. Why? Because it is due to some manufacturing problem, it is not available commercially. Whereas multi-mode fiber, there are two types. One is step index fiber and grade index fiber. The same different types of optical fiber available even in plastic optical fiber, single mode step index fiber and multi mode step index fiber. See the difference. Glass is a pure silica. Okay, plastic of course is a plastic material. Then the plastic optical fiber, we can use it for only short distance communication, and glass optical fiber we can make use of it for long distance communications. Now let us come to the point, step index of glass fiber, single mode step index fiber. No, glass optical fiber, multi mode step index fiber, glass multi mode grade index optical fiber. Now let us see that what do you mean by single mode fiber. Of course the fiber is support for only one mode, so called it is a single mode fiber. Then multi-mode fiber, the glass fiber or plastic fiber with support for more than one mode. Even if it is a two mode, ultimately it called it as a multi-mode fiber. So single mode only one mode support, multi-mode more than one mode supported called as a multi-mode fiber. Then come to the point, single mode, what is step index fiber? That is very important. Single mode step index fiber. So what is that single mode step index fiber? The step index and the grade index is nothing but depending upon the profile, refract index profile of optical fiber. Let us say that step index optical fiber, let's draw the optical fiber structure which consists of core and cladding medium. Okay, this is a core and this is a cladding. Okay, is a core denoted by N1, The cladding surrounded by cord. N2 and this is N2. N1 and N2. N1 is always greater than N2. So I am saying this is a single mode step index fiber. Mean it is, it consists of only one mode. Then what is, why it is called as a step index fiber? See, the refract index profile of the core medium, you know, the refract index, because it's made up of silica, the refract index is 1.5. That 1.5 refract index is constant throughout the core medium. Okay, then when you come to that interface of two different media, N1 and N2, the refract index is suddenly changed into cladding medium. Say for example, N1 equal to 1.5, then N2 equal to 1.49. Sudden changes at the, if you see that interface of two different media, okay, the below the interface 1.5, above the interface suddenly changes to 1.49. Step change, abrupt change, so called it is a single mode step index fiber. The refract index is suddenly changed into the cladding medium, so called it is a step index fiber. Whereas graded index optical fiber, the second method, graded index. Graded index fiber, it is not like that. See here, this is a core medium, this is a cladding medium. You can draw the structure of optical fiber. Okay, so this is a core and cladding. This is a center axis of the fiber. Okay, core and cladding. Core and cladding. Here, why it is called as a grade index optical fiber? The refract index of the core medium is gradually changes. Gradually changes. That is, the refract index of the core is gradually decreases from center axis of the core to the surface. Gradually decreases. Say for example, at the center axis, the refract index of the core is 1.5. Okay, then next layer, the 1.5 is gradually decreasing towards the interface of the core media. So 1.5, then 1.4999, then 1.498, then 1.497, like that. Up to that part, interface may be 1.490. Then abruptly changes 1.49. This is the cladding N2. Then these are all related to N1. See here, the refract index is gradually decreasing from center axis of the core to the interface. So called it is a graded index optical fiber. Okay, so here, glass optical fiber, it is a plastic optical fiber, is made up of silica. Glass is a plastic material. Application of a glass fiber is long distance communication and attenuation also less, but plastic optical fiber you can make use it for short distance communication. Attenuation will be more, transmission loss will be more. Then single mode, multi mode, step index and grade index optical fiber. Then single mode step index optical fiber is more advantage of compared to all other types of optical fiber. This is a fiber, one, we can use it for very long distance communications and produce lower attenuation compared to, you know, multi-mode step index as well as multi-grade index optical fiber. Why? Because of, in multi-mode optical fiber, there will be a chances of getting mode interference, okay, mode coupling, due to which there will be a attenuations. So in order to avoid more loss in multi-mode step index and multi-mode grade index, we can make use of single mode step index fiber for very long distance communications. This is a basic introduction about optical fiber and signal transmission through fiber. So next session we will discuss about what is a acceptance angle and what is a cone angle, what is a numerical aperture. This and all we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.